We're building this movement. And what we want to say is that every single person matters. You're not the worst thing that you did. Because at Clean Start, we don't say when we meet, you were guilty. I was innocent. No, we say you're not the worst thing you did.
Hey everybody, my name is Angie Murenga. You're watching Just Angie. It's Mwenye Inchi Monday, where we discuss all things governance, and we're talking about the prison system and the reformation of prisoners and rehabilitation. And also today I wanted to talk about Clean Start. So so you started Clean Start because you've been to prison. So there are two, I think I hear you talk about coaching and about
reintegration.
So take us through that.
So Clean Start was ideally founded by the women. We actually started meeting at Uhuru Park.
Which is so interesting.
And we would meet and I would ask, what is it we really want for ourselves? And the first thing we would say is, we want to be accepted back into society, to be given a second chance. We are not the worst thing that got us into prison. And to be honest with you, for most of them, they were innocent. Clean Start is a platform, which is a social enterprise that I founded for these women to come and first rebuild their self-esteem, rebuild their confidence and find themselves, get a footing. And once that happens, then the second step is, let's unlock our potential. And this is for both those who are still on the inside and those who are on the outside. And how do we unlock the potential? It's through the coaching program that we offer. And it's been a huge blessing because Clean Start has been licensed by an organization called Risago Trust, which is a charity in the UK that I got to know about through a lady called Joss Carathers, whom I met when I was pitching and talking about the vision that I have within Clean Start. And Joss was in her first weeks in Kenya, had come from being a coach in the UK with Risago Trust. And she told me about the SPEAR program. And SPEAR is a six-week mindset, attitudinal change coaching program. And in the UK, it's for 16 to 24-year-olds. So when she told me about it, I was like, how can we contextualize it to suit the women and the girls who we work with here? And that's the journey we embarked on from 2016 onwards. And so some of the women were trained to be coaches, and we'd go into the institutions, coach the women, coach the young girls. And what it does, it really, you know, seeks within themselves to get their best version, and then get it very clear. What is it that you really want to achieve as a woman? What is it you really want to achieve as a teenage girl? And once we find that, we bring in mentors, we bring in supporters who can journey with this woman or journey with this girl. So say the girl says, I want to go back into education. So we'll go out there, look for a school. And we've gotten schools. For instance, the Great Rift School in Eldoret is one of the schools that's taking some of our girls. And so they leave the institutions, go into these schools, and people will step in and offer scholarships to see to it that this girl completes her schooling. If it's the women, I want to start my small business or I want employment. And some of you, KEPSA has embraced us. It's incredible.
That's so encouraging.
It is. And we create awareness. We talk about exactly what happens and how most of these women and girls end up in these correctional institutions. And once people get to learn, they embrace how they'd like to support. So some of these women now have jobs. They go into these workplaces. The person who runs the organization mentors and understand that this girl or this woman is coming from a very traumatized background and journeys with them. And then some of these women, Fatia, for example, have started their own businesses. She runs Fatso's just near Kwea. And for every occasion we have, Fatia is the one who provides the food. And it's just incredible to even see these women hold each other's hands. August 31st, end of this month, we will have what we call the Overcomers Meeting, Champions of Change. That's what we call ourselves. And we're these women from across the country who will come together. And this is where we now meet, all of us have come out of prison. And we now share our stories. As I said, half our team at Clean Start are formerly imprisoned women. And they say, I'm working at Clean Start. This is what I do. Fatia and all the other women, I'm running my business. I'm doing this and that. The ones who've just come out, get encouraged.
Yes.
And get this platform where we meet on a regular basis to then offer peer-to-peer support, encouraging one another. Because one of the biggest challenges is depression.
Yeah.
When you come out of prison,
I can imagine.
You're so depressed. I remember how depressed I was. And so you need a sister telling you, get out of that depression.
Yes.
Join the dots. This is how we could do it. Mm. So-and-so is offering a job. Come. Is it bus fare you need? Is it a place to stay you need? And so these are the things where Clean Start is still struggling to look for support.
Yeah.
Safe houses.
Where you can shelter the women.
In
so
the
we
meantime.
We need safe houses. We need to build halfway houses.
Yes.
We need finances. To even give them seed capital.
Yeah.
We need to give opportunities for them to work.
Exactly.
We need mentors and coaches. Mm-hmm. Get some purpose in life.
Yeah.
And coach somebody to be better.
To be better.
And encourage them and get them out of the dark place that they are.
The dark places. Yeah.
Wow.
Where we could meet as overcomers. Because I'm always sourcing for where do we have our meeting. You know, Clean Start still does not have its permanent offices.
Yeah, we need somebody to provide an office.
An office space and a place where we could meet on a regular basis. Mm. We're building this movement. And what we want to say is that every single person matters. You're not the worst thing that you did. Because at Clean Start, we don't say when we meet, you were guilty. Mm. I was innocent. No, we say you're not the worst thing you did. You could have murdered, but you can come around that because God has still given you a second chance.
That's so true.
Repent, come clean.
Change.
And let's journey together to build this society and make it better.
And you need each other.
And we need each other. So overcomers, that's what we call ourselves, the champions of change. And I believe that's what we truly are. Mm. And we want to exemplify that people, when given opportunities, can truly become the best versions that they can be.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That is so amazing. So so much good came out of this whole prison system. I'm sure even the family of your husband, now they know that you're a good person.
Yes.
Families have come together.
Yes.
They're happy.
Yes.
You now have two children.
Yes.
And there's what's next for the for even the two of you and for the ministry.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm so excited about Clean Start. I'm so amazed at what we can do. And I hope government is out there listening.
Yeah.
And that you have to care about this people. We can't treat some Kenyans one way and other Kenyans another way.
Mm.
And therefore, I'm very, very encouraged, Teresa. I'm extremely, extremely, extremely encouraged.
Thank
really,
you.
Really, really amazed that good has come out of this.
True.
That there's a beautiful story now forming and will form, and there's impacts, and you're going to break very many people free from prison, actually literal prison, because I think even as I engage with you and the other women, I think there's a prison when you're incarcerated, but there's a prison even after you come out.
Yes.
And you also have to break out of that one because you're given freedom, but you feel like you're still imprisoned and you're still in bondage and captivity.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore we have to get ourselves out of that prison.
Yeah.
And I think also it's normal for human beings to even imprison yourself now, you know, it's like you're stuck, you can't get out.
Mm.
They've given you freedom, literally, but there's a freedom that needs to be unlocked within you as a spirit and as a human being, which I think you're really offering, which is really, really encouraging and amazing.
True.
And therefore we love God because, hey, for sure, at the end of it, we can see the light at the end
of the tunnel.
Yeah. And then you only did 8 months,
and
then you came out, and then you completely cleared your name.
Yeah.
And that was good. You even got a certificate of conduct because you told me you did that one.
Yeah.
Although even then, those ones were not giving you good reports. They don't know, hey, you had to get a certificate of conduct and they were not saying good things.
Things,
about you.
Yeah.
And it seemed everybody knew. Anyway, God is good.
True.
He really is.
He really is a good God.
He's a good God. Mm. He's a vindicator.
Yeah.
And he does good by us.
True.
So I can't wait to see what will happen for this Clean Start journey. Yeah. Yeah. Please, if you're out there, in whatever way you can help, in a legislative capacity, in a policy capacity, in a financial capacity, in an emotional capacity, in a social capacity, if you know the right doors to open and to connect to the right people, please, we've got to do something. And wherever you are, and if you're out there in the counties, find a prison and do something, you know. I think even you were, I saw you with the... with the gentleman Yusuf from how they, is it how when they see us?
When they see us.
Yeah, so I saw the prison system, prisons are disturbing everyone all over the world. So that must have been so encouraging to see, to be with Yusuf and to meet them because, that was another horror story.
Yeah.
And even the prison also was a horror story because I remember from the movie, especially this part where there's been no air con and this guy is in the cell. You know, you just wonder, I was even asking, you know, I was asking myself questions I watched the movie why do you, even if the person is in solo confinement because other people want to injure him, must you punish him now? Is this a punishment or we're rehabilitating people? God help us.
It's encouraging.
But I think we're on a good journey.
We are. Let's keep choosing right over wrong, because when we choose what's wrong over what's right, then we keep going the wrong direction. So no matter how difficult, no matter how unpopular, let's choose what's right.
Yeah.
It will pay off for us as a society.
I'm so grateful.
Wow.
I hope you've enjoyed the series. Like I have, I'm challenged. I have many questions. I have... what do I do? I'm really praying that I'm not those people who are not going to do anything. And I think also I want to end on the note of, please remember the things that can take you to prison.
Yeah.
Hot tempers need to be addressed.
Yeah.
Anger needs to be addressed. Consumption of alcohol needs to be addressed.
Yeah.
Drunk driving needs to be addressed by you. You can't go around fighting with everyone, bullying people. If you push somebody and they fall, they hit their head, that's the end of your life. There's a lady who I'm also going to bring here who even poured acid on the mistress of the husband. Yani, just stop. And you know, I remember when I was in, when I think I'll end there, when I went to visit and I was so upset because of the crimes of passion. But then as I did, the Lord convicted me, but there's another way. You can actually walk away. You know, crimes of passion, you don't have to kill the person. You can, there's actually another option. Maybe you can even injure them, but you can walk away.
You can.
And that's why they think they still incarcerate you, because you have an option. The option is not to kill somebody else. The option is to take off, disappear, go as far as possible as you can. And that means also dealing with things, you know. I think even this series, you have to deal with things. You can't just let things just play out, because at the end there's going to be a tragedy. At some point, if there's violence and you're being mistreated, you need to get out. You need to go. Because you don't want to injure somebody. You can't take somebody's life. I think that's the bottom line.
That's the bottom
line. You can't take somebody's life. But just think through it. Also, those ones who are partying and look at the lifestyle you want, the things that you want that you're not ready to delay. And you want them today, so you're hanging out with people. There's mostly women. You're hanging out with men who can provide these things for you. But you don't know what other underhand dealings are going on. People are dealing drugs. People are carrying money as mules because there's a lifestyle you want. Then that whole lifestyle ends so suddenly because you find yourself in a prison. Like, there's no point. Please look at your circumstances. Look at your situations around you and figure out why are you in a situation that, or a lifestyle that can actually lead you to incarceration, and just stop. And don't steal, don't be corrupt, please don't. So I'm just thinking about all the reasons. Sit down and think about all the reasons that can make you go to prison, and don't do it. Don't do it. Just walk away from that and change, and let's change. God bless you. Thank you so much for coming, Teresa. I'm so encouraged. I am so happy. Grateful.
It's an honor. It's an honor. It's also a privilege for us to be able to hold hands and see how we will empower many others and see what's the way forward.
God bless you.
Thank you.
And God bless you greatly.
Amen. And you
Salimia Njoroge sana.
I will.
And keep going at Clean Start.
Yeah.
Keep going. Keep moving.
Thank
they
you.
Need you. And I love that you said you're going to be a voice.
Yes.
Be their voice.
Yeah.
Speak for them.
Mm.
God bless you. And intercessors out there, pray
yeah.
for people, especially when nightfall falls, for mothers who don't know where their children are.
Mm.
And government, if you're listening, please, let's put our heads together and come up with a solution that's going to work. Because how we treat the lowest of the low in this nation is going to affect us. On one hand, we want God to bless us.
Mm.
But how is he going to bless us if his people are crying out for justice?
Yeah.
God bless you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.